Okay, I'm going to cover a little bit of half guard today and talk mostly about one of the subpositions of half guard. But a general introduction to half guard is half guard on the bottom is when you have half guard, you're probably going to have your legs either over here on this side or over here on this side, right? And one thing you do when your legs are here is you can trap his foot like this and drag it out into the lockdown position. And one of the reasons you would want to do lockdown position is if you don't, if he's able to be up on his knees and up here real high, he can come up and he's got base and he can be punching with both hands, right? If you drag his leg back, lockdown, drag it back like that, now he can't bring that knee up. He's got to try to hold himself up with one hand and punch with the other hand, and it's pretty easy to defend against that. So that takes away some of his punching. So those are the general positions you do with your legs. As far as your upper body, where your arms are, the situations you're going to be in are going to be usually either he's got double underhooks here, right? And this is bad for you because you really can't do much with your arms. You can try to choke him, but probably not going to get that. Or very common is he's wrapped around your head and under this arm, or he may be over here. Usually he'll sit his body more to the side this way and be just attacking this arm, okay? So those are the positions that he may be in. As far as your best positions are going to be, first of all, if he's got double underhooks like this, you want to be trying to work your way so you have underhooks here. One of the things you can do when you get your underhooks here is now you can start, he doesn't have much to attack, and start bumping him up on the side, coming out and go to his back. Also, let's switch around to this side. So, one thing you can, another position you can go for here that I kind of like is just so he has nothing to attack, is try to get your arms, try to get to this position here where your arms are here. Now, he can't get under your arms, so you really don't have your arms to attack. You're also free to start doing some other techniques, including going for more arm locks and other things from that position. All right, so now let's take a look at some things you can do when you have, or when your opponent has head and arm control. So we're under his half guard, right? And he's got this arm is under my head, and this arm is under my arm. So one thing I may want to do is try to get both my arms get double underhooks, right? Because as I showed you before, he has less control, I have more control. Tough to do, because he's real tight on me, chest to chest. So one thing that you can do to that situation is you take this hand is free, I can push his head up that direction to the opposite corner, drive up, I get a little bit of space, and then this arm comes across and continues pushing up, right? Getting a little space, and quickly here, I'm gonna bring this hand here. Now I've got this, he's still trying to be tight on me, but I've got some drive, I can create a little space, and with that space, I can usually get this arm through here, and then take the other one and follow it, and I have double underhooks. So that's the first one you can do. Next thing you might want to do is, because he's got this arm underneath my head, this arm is, when this is underneath your neck, it's really hard for you to move. It's a very controlling position for him. So what I could do here is hook his foot, cross my legs, right, hook his foot with my foot, and drive him back, right? That sprawls him back. Now from here, I'm gonna grab his hand behind my neck, and then with that same lockdown position, I'm gonna pull him forward. Watch what happens to his body. So he's gonna drive forward, and he can't base with this hand. He can't put his hand out to stop himself and go that direction. So I'm gonna drive forward, take his arm around, and now I've escaped his arm from under my neck, and I have a lot more play with my body here. All right, and the third thing we can do in that situation is, if our feet are crossed on the outside here, and he still has the head and arm control here, right? One thing I can do is take this hand, brace against his knee. Okay, I'm doing this against his knee. That's gonna stop him from following me forward as I start to shrimp out this direction. So I brace against his knee, foot to the ground, slide back, take this foot under hook, his thigh here, and now I can lift him up, kick over, and elevator this direction, go to the other side, and take side control. is similar but slightly different technique I can do is this time I'm going to cross my legs, underhook his foot, the shin, drive it back in lockdown. And now I stretch his leg out in lockdown. I release this leg, come underneath, and hook inside, right? So I have space as I grab his leg back. From there, I'm going to reach and grab his ankle here, or pant leg if that's all I get. Lift it up, overhook it, use the elevator, come over and get the top position. Okay, half guard again. I'm doing it on the other side just so I can demo here. So this time we're just going to put it back in the guard, simple technique. So usually I'm going to want my feet crossed on the outside here. I'm halfway there already. So what we're going to do is this hand is going to go to his knee. If he's up higher, that's going to be my elbow, right? That goes to the knee, blocks the knee. This foot just goes to the ground here, shrimp my hips out this direction, come up here. Then shrimp my hips the other way, keep going this direction. Put him back in the guard. While I'm doing that, technique, if he starts following me, if I'm blocking here, get out here, he's following me, I can push on his shoulders here to keep pushing him away so I get that space and put him back in. Okay, this time we're going to put him into butterfly guard. So he's got head and arm, just like every other technique we've done here. So this time, cross my feet, my legs, underhook his leg, drive it back, right? His hand comes to his hip down here. This arm is going to overwrap since he's already under it. I'm just going to overwrap and control it. And I release this foot, strip out of my half to get my foot inside here. And I'm going to lift him up and push him away. Push away. And that allows me to bring my other leg in, and I've got butterfly guard. This time we're going to reverse and get the top position. We'll still be in his half guard. But you may be able to work better from there. So we're going to use techniques similar to what we already did. So he's got head and arm again, right? This time we're going to lock down, cross your legs, drag his leg back out. This hand comes behind your head and traps his wrist here. Now he can't base his hand out, right? So we're going to, like we did before, we're going to pull him forward. Oh, that allows you to escape your head. This hand's going to block his knee. So he can't push his leg out to the side and prevent himself from rolling. He's going to block his knee. Now he can lift and take the top position from here. And one more technique based on one that we already did earlier. So this time we're going to, this arm escaped, right? We want to get, so we have both double underhooks. So we'll use a technique we did earlier. That one is we're going to push. He's got head and arm, right? Take this free hand, push it up that direction. Get your other hand in so you can push with both arms. Now you have to quickly bring this arm underneath. You got some space here. That allows you to drive this other arm underneath, right? Now, and then this hand escapes underneath as well. Now he's got nothing stopping from going that direction. You want to try to drive him to get your head to this side of his body. Now when your head's on this side of his body, you can shrimp your hips out, start coming out, working out to get to the back.